Hi, I'm John Cranton. Let's talk American League Baseball over the weekend, a weekend series starting on Friday as the Yankees head to Texas to take on the Rangers. This is a rematch of the American League Championship Series from last October, won by Texas in five games. You got a battle of two terrific offensive teams. They're also battling for first place in their divisions. Now, the Yankees come in outstanding offense, number one in slugging in Major League Baseball, number six in runs scored. All kinds of talent up and down this offensive lineup with A-Rod, newcomer Russell Martin at catcher, plus Curtis Granderson, who has really bounced back. Remember with Granderson, it was last August that they reworked his swing, and ever since then, 22 home runs. That is third best in baseball. Now, the Yankees, with respect to the total, have had a very unusual start to the season. They started 8-3 over the total. You can expect that with their offense and some suspect pitching. And they turned around and went 7 of 8 games under the total. Now, the starters for this series, you're looking at young Ivan Nova, 24-year-old hurler, hasn't been very good with an ERA over 5. And one of the problems with him is walks. In his first 28 innings pitched, 15 walks. That's way too much. And in his career against Texas, he's 0-1 with an ERA over 10. You also have Bartolo Colon, the veteran, 37 years old, not all overpowering stuff, and yet he's had a great start to the season for the Yankees. During a recent four-game stretch, they won three games in that series, and his numbers were outstanding. 26 innings pitched, just 23 hits, only 6 walks and 26 strikeouts. Career-wise against Texas, Colon, 17 wins and 6 losses. And then ACC Sabathia will be available. He's just money in the bank. 2-1 on the season, 2.25 ERA. Lifetime against Texas, 8 wins, 3 losses. Now keep in mind, Yankees as a road underdog, just 1-7. And they've played the fewest road games of any American League team. That's something to watch for this weekend series. Now, Texas has not been a good road team, but they've been dominant at home. And the offense, number 5 in runs scored, number 2 in slugging. Pitching lineups for this series, lefty Matt Harrison, very good in his career, just a mediocre start for this season. And he has a 2-1 record against the Yankees, although the ERA is over 5. Then you get Derek Holland, a lefty who's a soft thrower, and he can get by against some marginal offenses, but he's been terrible in his career against the powerhouse Yankee lineup, 0-3 against them with an ERA over 8. Love to pound the soft stuff. And then you got a guy who's just the opposite in Alex Ogando, a former reliever. He's transitioned to starter, been outstanding. 3-0 record, 2.30 ERA, practically no hits allowed. This guy doesn't walk anybody. He's outstanding arm. Now, these teams have already met April 15th to 17th. The Yankees took 2 out of 3 at home, and it was a close series. The average score was 5-4. And make a note that when the total in the Yankee game is between 7 and 8.5, they are 19-7 over the total. And Texas on the season, when they face a lefty like Sabathia, they're 6-1 over the total. Look for an intense series in this one. Probably a lot of high-scoring games, too, as the ballpark in Arlington is very small. Now, if you're looking for winning plays all weekend long, Jim Feist has baseball plays available right here on this website. Plus, he's 3-0 with NBA playoff games of the year, and there'll be more available right here on this site. That's all. We'll see you next week, and enjoy the games.